My favorite day is Tuesday.
Enjoy some peanut butter fudge today.
Darren should, because tomorrow's Wednesday.
Alright guys, let's start from the beginning of the week.
No, me, Bosco, and Albert will.
His name is Dripmaster.
It was the face for me. He just goes,
you're not.
He goes,
good morning, Central. Welcome to Friday. Nationally, it has been a heavy, intense week. So we have something to lighten the mood. For all the old people in the building, here's a 1980s flashback. Everybody's working for the weekend. Everybody wants a new
romance. Everybody's going off the deep end.
Okay, so let's just talk about this for a minute. Yes, we are all working for the weekend. Who doesn't love time off? Plus, I love the 1980s perms, the orange suit, and even the orange headband. Pure 80s. You're welcome, teachers. What else can we talk about? Well, because it's my thing, let's cover some quick politics. President Biden has already signed more than 17 executive orders, and I like this. Starting next week, his daily goals will have a theme such as Buy American. It will be interesting to see how Biden's presidency plays out. One thing I know, though, is we are witnessing many historic firsts in our nation. That is a lot of good things today. But I am afraid the weather may not be so good. Let's find out. Weather with John.
Thanks, Eli. Hey, guys. So we are heading into some cold weather, but I'm not seeing any snow in the near future. Today, there will be some sunshine, but the low is going to dip in the 19 degrees or so. The weekend looks similar with the highs in the low 30s and lows in the high teens. We should see some sunshine again tomorrow, but Sunday and Monday, it will be cloudy. With that, let's head over to Hunter for some sporting news.
Thanks, John. Well, tonight we have some exciting games. Our boys' basketball teams are getting on the bus for that long ride to Lancaster. They take on the Golden Gales. And tonight, our Lady Comets Ballers are also taking on the Gales, but they are at home. What else you got going on, Talasia?
Well, first, thanks for the basketball news, Hunter. We've got more Comet news, though. Our gymnastics team has a busy weekend. Tonight, they are taking on Delaware at Delaware, and tomorrow, they are traveling to Olin, TNG. Plus, our wrestlers are on the way to New Albany on Saturday. A lot of away games and bus travel this weekend. Please remember to text your athlete friends and wish them good luck.
Thanks, Talasia. We also have some results from last night. The wrestling team fell to Newark last night, 52-21. Picking up some wins for the Comets were Donnie Morris, Michael Bradshaw, Abel, and Max Webb. Congrats, guys. The team, as Talasia already said, is back in action on Saturday at New Albany with Olin Tangi.
Good job, wrestlers. I have more result news. Last week, the swim team had their first meet of the season against Taze Valley, Westland, and Zane Trant, and both girls and boys teams were victorious. Many swimmers competed in their first events, and others started the year with new personal records.
A special congratulations to the following swimmers for winning their events. Haley Howard in the 50 and 500 freestyle, Lance Howard in the 50 freestyle, Matt Groom in the 200-meter and 100-meter backstroke, Unaya Neville in the 100 freestyle, Maverick Smith in the 100 breaststroke, and Mitchell Smith in the 200 freestyle and 100 butterfly. Additionally, the girls 400 freestyle relay and the boys medley and 400 relays won their events. Great job, swimmers, and we look forward to your meet next against the team to the east.
Wow. Thanks for all the sporting news, and good luck to all of our athletes competing over the next few days. We are rooting for you. Now, guess what time it is? Guess what time it is? Drum roll, please. It's time for Comet Kindness. This is the time when a teacher gives a shout out to a student. Today, we have Mr. Moss.
Hey, Comets. This is Dr. Moss. I'm the choir teacher here at Central Crossing. Today, I want to recognize Jacob Schwartz. Jacob is such a hardworking student, and he's really just a sponge for knowledge. He loves to try new things. He's actually relatively new to choir, having just joined, I think, last year. And for somebody who's so new, he's just really thrown himself in and tried to experience everything he can. He took a solo to, he was one of just three students who took a solo to solo an ensemble this fall and got an excellent rating. He worked so hard on it on his own. He's very self-motivated. And back in December, when we were at home, I had students work on a project of their own choosing, and Jacob chose this really fantastic project on modernist music from all throughout the 20th century, and he turned it into this huge presentation that was like 30 minutes long, full of examples and insights and research that he had done and shared. So I want to recognize Jacob today. He's really a true example of what it means to be a comet.
Congratulations, Jacob. You prove what a comet should be, and everyone in this building appreciates you. Next, because we know everyone does their part around here, we're going to roll a wheel to celebrate some random students. We're starting with freshman and sophomore Green Group. Roll that wheel!
Congratulations, Brian. Now let's roll the wheel for our junior and senior Green Group. Here we go. Roll that wheel.
Congratulations, Leticia. So, Jacob, Brian, and Leticia, today we celebrate you. Thanks to each of you and everyone for showing the virtues of a comet. We are respectful, responsible, and take time to recognize each other's accomplishments. Plus, comets are resilient.
Have a great weekend.
We'll see you on Thursday.
Stay safe, stay smart, and remember, always stay 6 feet apart.
Remember, today is the last day for your semester-only classes. We will start the second semester classes on Monday, January 25th. If you don't know where your classes are, use your time prior to the warning bell to take a look around.
Have a great day. And if you're a procrastinator like me, make sure to get all of your work in today.
Have a great day, Comets. And by the way, you guys should enjoy some brownies tonight because it is National Brownie Day. So enjoy those brownies, Comets. Have a great day.